for about two decades through 2006, volume companies outperform growth companies by about 1% per year. Suddenly, all of that changed on a dime, because since 2006, growth companies outperformed value companies by about 2% per year. And that discrepancy, that gap, is getting wider and wider, with companies such as Amazon and Facebook and Google, also Netflix, leading the pack. And the biggest question is when that gap is going to start narrowing, when value is going to start outperforming growth stocks again. What I have to say is that we as investors have to be extremely apprehensive about that turn of events that might come again. Because a lot of these value companies, in my view, are also a value trap, with the exception of some names. Naturally, Microsoft was an exception to the rule. This was a value play a few years ago, selling at 10 times earnings. And with their new CEO that came in and the newly discovered revenue stream in the cloud, the company started digging itself out of that value play. And today, Microsoft is selling, as we all know it, about 30 times earnings. We need to look for these plays such as Microsoft, these deep value investments that, in my view, can become a growth play. Some companies that come to mind can be GM, a company that sells at 6 times earnings with $15 billion in cash on their books, additional $15 billion in borrowing power to give them enough leeway and liquidity to be ready to launch their Cruise autonomous driving service, a company that pays 4% in dividends, one of the cheapest companies on the S&P 500, with a technology kick to it. Their hybrid vault business is not completely hybrid. I would say it's 2/3 completely hybrid, but gives individuals that are buying these cars 1/3 of the cost that they pay with any other company. And that business is growing 58% per year. Other companies that are deep value plays can be Bank of America, selling at 10 times earnings, paying north of 2% dividends, buying back their own shares. Goldman Sachs can be another play. And when we speak about value, interestingly enough, Amazon one day can fall into that category because they are slowly growing into more of a value play. I remember when Amazon was selling at 300 to 500 times earnings. If Amazon were to hit their numbers and they will start making about $40 a share in 2020, that means Amazon is selling now at about 50 times earnings, as opposed to other companies in that space, like Shopify, ticker symbol Shop, selling at 500 times earnings in the same e-commerce space. I also wanted to talk about the earnings season that is coming. So expectations are for zero growth. The market is not expecting to see any revenue growth or net income growth in the third quarter. However, if we were to adjust to some upside surprises by analysts, we might see 2.5% growth rate in earnings. But if we were to adjust it back to buybacks, we're going to go back to zero. The fourth quarter is going to be a little bit different because the comparisons to the fourth quarter of 2018 are going to become a lot easier. So the market is looking at about 7% growth rate in earnings for the fourth quarter. But if we were to do the same thing, adjusting to buybacks, I think we should expect to see at the end of 2019 about 3.5 to 4% earnings growth, which is not too bad, but there is some slowdown coming.
So there are several and many cloud providers out there, Amazon, Google, Microsoft, IBM, Oracle, and even Alibaba. For this portion, I'll focus on the top three since they have a good portion of the market share. The spend on infrastructure in 2018 exceeded $80 billion. This was actually 46% growth as well from 2017, so a lot there. The company with the most market share is AWS, or Amazon Web Services. They saw infrastructure spend from enterprises of $25.4 billion, and that's with a 31.7% of the market share in 2018. And this is 47.1% annual growth from 2017, so they are still growing within that. Second there is Microsoft Azure, and they saw infrastructure spend from enterprises of $13.5 billion with 16.8% of the market share in 2018. And in terms of their growth, they saw 82.4% annual growth from 2017. So they are growing more than Amazon, even though Amazon has more of the market share. GCP, or Google Cloud Platform, saw infrastructure spend from enterprises of $6.8 billion and with 8.5% of the market share in 2018. But they saw the most growth year over year of 93.9% of the growth from 2017. This is not a winner-take-all market. There are a lot of companies out there with a strategy to use a multi-cloud strategy to diversify away their risk, but also in terms of an ability to compete with Amazon, because a lot of the competitors are out there that have IT infrastructure needs but don't necessarily want to host and use the capabilities of their competitor. These three companies we're watching closely in a very interesting space.
Only 10% of Californians actually have earthquake insurance. It's a little higher in LA and Orange counties at 21%, 9% of people in Riverside, and 8% of people in San Bernardino have earthquake insurance. The question of should you buy it, right? On the pro side, you wanna protect your investment in the house. If something happens to your house and you still owe money on it, you're still gonna owe money on the house and you gotta pay for a new place to live. On the con side, well, it's really expensive. Deductibles can be as high as 10 to 20% of the total insured value. There's not a whole lot of people that own it, so the price is still high. If more people buy it, the price of the insurance will go down.
Keeping an eye on the yield curve, the 10-year treasury today is sitting at 2.03 after a better than expected job report last Friday. We did see markets react to that, so it gives another indication of how sensitive markets can be to potential interest rate cuts or increases. The 2-year to the 10-year still has not inverted, but that has gone as low as 17 basis points on Friday. So we see some narrowing there. As far as the short-term rates, the 1 to 3 month to the 10-year, that remains at about an 18 basis point inversion. The 2-year to the 3-year remains inverted consistently at about 7-8 basis points.
Hello everybody, and thank you for watching our videos. I'm Amit Stavinsky, the Managing Director of Tamar Securities and its affiliates, 911 Financial Services and Firefighters United. As always, if you like the content, become a subscriber. Also, you can call us directly to our main offices in Woodland Hills at 818-914-7461. The highlight of the week is that value investments at one point or another should start outperforming growth investments. However, in the process for looking for good value plays that can become growth plays, investors should stay away from value traps.